gets to drive the 13 Mitigator Ford Fusion. I'd like to thank you for listening to Let's Talk Racing.tv.
Driver of the number 5 Kiker Motorsports Camry. Welcome to Let's Talk Racing TV.
Holly Kimmel with Rockingham Speedway. Thanks for listening to Let's Talk Racing.
I'm Teddy Peter, driver of the number 17 Toyota in the NASCAR Camp World Truck Series, and you're listening to Let's Talk Racing.
I'm Daytona 500 winner Trevor Bayne, and thank you for watching Let's Talk Races.
Hi, this is Dylan Smith. I'd like to thank you for listening to Let's Talk Racing.
Hi, I'm Amber Colvin. I'd like to thank you for watching Let's Talk Racing.
Hello everybody, I'd like to welcome you to Let's Talk Racing. I'm trying to get things rolling here today. Got some people running late. And people that are not savvy on time zones. So bear with me. Oh, what can I say? All right. All the good fun things. Let's see what we got going on here. Apologize, I thought I'd, my partner in crime, I had two of them scheduled for the night. Halloween struck again. The kids are winning the adults. Hopefully everybody enjoyed the Martinsville race. I was out there hoping Tony Stewart would pull it off, but I reckon it wasn't to be done. Hark, I hear somebody entering. Maybe I'll have my other half of my people here, or at least one third.
Call from Krystal Hurr.
Yo. Where I should be. It's already after 7. Lock the front door.
Roger, I'm at your office.
Where do you think your show started 5 minutes ago?
I didn't know that you moved it back here.
Oh.
Like, I know you moved it, but I didn't know it was all the way back here.
Well.
So I didn't know where I was going. I just kind of...
Come on in and plant your booty.
I just kind of followed. Hey, everybody. I'm in the spirit of Halloween. I'm still dressed up.
Why is that not coming?
So who all we have on the show tonight? Holy cow, this is completely different.
Traffic. You failed to plan.
I did plan. I left around 6:20.
Didn't plan. Oh, that's the same thing. Failed to plan is didn't plan.
I did plan. What are you saying? I didn't plan when I planned.
Anywho. I was just getting ready to start talking about Martinsville.
Oh, Lord. Martinsville. That was interesting. I didn't get to see the truck race. He got to see it. You were lucky for that one. I got to see the cup race.
Yeah, it wasn't as bad as the previous one was.
No, because this one didn't have really any wrecks or anything wrong or bad happen. Apparently the truck race had a lot of wrecks, but by the time I got to the hotel, I got to the last couple laps, so I missed out on the truck race.
Bad part is you probably could have looked on cable and found it again. But
anyway, I know, but...
What can we say? Mm. So I see you got your dressed down for Halloween, is that what it is?
Yes, I'm dressed for Halloween. I'm very dispirited. I love Halloween. I go all out. I dress up when I pass out candy so people can actually you know, just not come up and get a piece of candy. They actually can be entertained by someone being dressed up like them. I'm in the spirit of the holiday, which is a good thing.
Well, off subject, Disney Films is buying, or Disney is buying Lucasfilms.
Really?
Planning to have another Star Wars movie out by 2015.
No.
$4 billion they bought them for.
But they're gonna make another Star Wars? Do you think it's gonna be any good? Are we all gonna compare it to the originals and be like, it's not the same? Like,
the effects are gonna be a lot better.
Well, they're gonna be a lot better than that. In that sense. And I have stories to tell about Martinsville, people I literally ran into, literally.
You get tickets for that.
No, as in they bumped into me.
Oh, goodness. Let's see.
So who will we have on the show?
Oh, I'm on the wrong page. We have Joe Scarbrough calling in at 7:15.
Yes, that's my buddy! Anyways, so we have Joe, then who else?
And we're going to have Hannah Newhouse calling in at 7:45.
Awesome. Is that it?
We have a short story. The hard part was everybody...
Can I have my buddy Philip Molinax call?
If you want to.
Like, he's a race car driver. Give me the number for here, and I can give it to him.
757.
Well, I know that, duh.
727.
727.
Then 9263.
When should I have him call?
If you want to have him call now, this is the open time slot.
Call now if you
I was sitting here
anyways.
To see,
But besides this going on Star Wars, I think it'll be good in the sense that the effects can be better. But then again, like, everybody's going to compare it to, like, the original storyline and how that goes. Like, if they mess that up, I think people will be kind of upset about it.
Get over it.
I know, but you know how fans can be.
How bad did y'all get anything with the storm?
Nothing too bad with Hurricane Sandy around the Newport News area. We got flooding in my yard. Like, it was up to our ankles, and our street didn't flood that bad. Isabel was really flooded. We didn't have any trees fall or anything like that, so not major damage in my area. Lost power for, like, a little bit, but then it came right back on about 20 minutes. Nothing bad in my area, but Outer Banks is, like, wiped out. Pocosin is really flooded. Fox Hill, where Uncle John's at, he was the smart guy to raise his house because it wasn't a pretty sight there. Like, I saw all the pictures and everything with the news. He said, we're going to talk about racing because it's called Let's Talk Racing. Duh.
Well, I mean, we're racing around the country covering news.
I know. About racing. Duh.
But anywho, I was sitting here zipping around looking at stuff, so.
Oh, I can get him a call.
Another one thing I didn't do yet. But, so, what'd you like about Martinsville most?
Martinsville? I like the track, because I've never had a track, but I've never been to a real short track before, so it made it really, really good race. Because it was really cool, because when the corner we sat at, they slow down, and then you just see the cars take off straight away, and it's a really good race to watch. And usually, like you said, there's a lot of crashes, but this year there wasn't many crashes, which is a good thing because that way nobody can get hurt. And then again, like you've told me, but it also gets people interested if there's crashes. So.
Well, I mean, the biggest thing out there, and there was some of it going on. People were having to tap the driver to get him to move over and scoot on along.
Like, just to move along. It's like, okay, you can go now. You're going too slow. Hopefully he'll call. I don't know if he'll call or not.
Oh, well.
Hopefully he will. Do you have him as a friend? I'll have to submit him or something to you. But Martinsville was fun.
Yeah, he's on my list, I believe.
Yeah. Martinsville was a lot of fun. Should I tell him about the story about who bumped into me? While I was looking through photos, because I told my grandma about that. She was like,
"Oh, you're talking about Junior?"
Yeah. So I was looking through the photos that I've taken earlier. I was deleting some and looking at some, you know, for the good ones for Roger to put up later on his site and everything. And I feel somebody kind of brush me and bump into me a little bit. I hear the word sorry and I say, oh, there's no problem. I look over. I don't realize who it is at first. And then as soon as he starts walking, he puts on these glasses and I realize it was Dale Earnhardt Jr. And he had one of his workers, his crew guy, standing beside him. So as soon as I finally realize, nobody knows he's around. Nobody knows he's walking through to get to his trailer, which is kind of a good thing. And so I tried to get some pictures, but he was walking so fast, he disappeared like that. I had no idea that it was him until too late, and I was kind of in shock because I'm like, okay, that was just Earnhardt Jr., my mom's favorite driver. She had a fit when I called her.
Well, what can I say?
Yeah.
Inexperience.
Sorry that I didn't realize. I wish I did. If I did, I probably would have got a picture. Better pictures.
Yeah, I still haven't had a chance to go through them. I almost forgot I had the camera still sitting in the car for the show. I'm sitting here, oh, I got plenty of time, 15 minutes.
Because I'm waiting for you to load all these photos, because you always tag me in them, and you're, like, loading millions of photos. And I'm waiting. And
well, there was this little thing
anything.
Called Hurricane
True.
Sandy.
Hurricane Sandy. The so, pain in the butt is what she is. She's
I didn't want to do all that stuff with because we had the lights go up and down a couple of times.
Yeah, I know how it is. You're fine. Usually Joe's online. He's not online. Oh, he said that he's with his family on to eat. So, but next time he says that he'll be.
Oh, you already got a message back?
Yeah.
Okay. And then I'll cancel sending that to him then.
No, you can still send it.
How's this gonna tell him? Says Krystal, why don't you get your ass on the phone?
Pretty much. You can tell him that. He's my buddy. He is my buddy.
Racer at PM Racing in Winter Haven, Florida.
Yeah.
Phil Happy Mullinex.
Yeah, he's a happy guy. That's his daughter there. He's got two daughters and they're so cute.
Yeah. But anyway, back to Martinsville.
Back to Martinsville.
You got to eat your first Martinsville hot dog.
Yes, that was really good.
Next year, we'll let you lead the competition into who can eat the most.
You know I will not last a second in that. Do you see me?
Exercise. Exercise.
I know people say I need meat on these bones of mine, but
Have you seen how many times people go out to the tracks and stuff and they have... I think Martinsville used to have a hot dog eating competition.
Well, we need to start
again. And little skinny guys were winning this stuff. I mean...
That wouldn't be me, because after my first hot dog, I'd be full. I'd be like, okay, I'm done.
Just go run around the track a couple of laps and you'll be hungry again.
No, because then somebody would have won by then. Do we want to tell them our idea for next year?
Well, it was just...
If we do this.
They register and... Everybody pays, you know, $5 or $10 to sign up, but it goes to charity.
Yeah. It goes to charity. So
but
we get
we're also
going to,
whoever eats the most hot dogs in a day will get a cash prize. $250, something like
so
that.
So, not only give money to charity, if you win, you can get $250. That sounds pretty good to me. You can buy yourself a t-shirt or a hat, you know.
A couple of tickets to the next race.
Yeah, tickets to the next race even. Look at that. All that in one day, just for eating a bunch of hot dogs.
But I'll have to get up with Mike about that. Smith, the PR guy out there, so.
Sounds good to me, though. Have we decided a charity, or are we going to think about that every time?
I was several charities I know, so.
Yeah.
We still got to do the thing for, was it Steve Snow?
Yeah. Steve King Foundation.
Steve King Foundation. We have
we still have to sell that and get the money for that.
Start getting that out there on eBay. And
I gave you the names.
I gotta find them again.
I give it to you and then you lose them?
Not necessarily.
Then you lose
We have people in the shop that like to move things around.
Yeah, blame it on the people in the shop
That's what happens when you're only here 2 hours a day.
I haven't been here in a while, actually. So.
I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about me. Huggies. Huggies is going to be on Juan Pablo's car.
Really?
Yeah. And let's see, on Truex Jr., he's going to take and do a relief effort for Hurricane Sandy on the 56.
That's awesome. Thank you so much, Truex Jr. That's so nice of you to help out a lot of the people. Because, like, North Carolina is, like, our next-door neighbor state. And, of course, we have family down there.
Yeah, he...
And that's a big effect on people.
Now, he's from my out of New Jersey.
Oh, really?
So he was...
Oh, yeah, New Jersey got hit bad on the news. They said some pictures of flooding, and I told Mom it looked almost like how Katrina after New Orleans and how that hit.
Did you hear the scam? I don't want to really call it a scam, but...
Did I hear about what?
Romney. They had that thing where they were talking about collecting food to take to the people in New Jersey. I think they were in Ohio.
Yeah, and I haven't heard about this, so what happened? Inform me.
The campaign committee... took $5,000 and bought food because it looked like nobody was bringing anything to him. And they took and had to buy their own food to put in there to make it look like people were actually donating.
Oh, wow.
He must not have been a good pull.
That's a little sad. I mean, come on, if you're just going for your cause is to help people out, I mean, but gee, that's interesting.
Anyway, yeah, Huggies Snug and Dry Diapers. I know you still use those.
Oh, ha, ha.
They're going to be on...
He still has the sense of humor, ladies and gentlemen. He's not lost that.
Number 42 car.
Yeah.
Juan Pablo Montoya.
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to be... This is going to be the first time...
Ooh, a Chevy. Yes.
Sorry. Yeah, they got leak lock, too, by the way.
Anyway. And Green Earth. Awesome. Official green partner of NASCAR. Venus Technologies.
They're going to be the official green partner of NASCAR.
That is awesome because we really need to help out the planet. I'm all about helping the Earth and all that stuff. My brother calls me hippie, but I'm not. I just love nature and I like to help nature out.
They're going to be a contingency program on the Wheel and Modified series. And the Wheel and All American Series, South Modified Tour, K&M Pro Tour. So they're going to be stickers on all sorts of cars now.
Awesome. And then what else? Oh, I'm talking to Joe.
Talking to Joe already?
Ahead of time. Is that Joe?
let's see. Let's talk racing.
Happy Halloween.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Hey, Joe. Okay, Roger, really?
Okay, yes.
Anyway, I'm doing great. How you been?
Very busy. I'm sorry I called in a little late. We're putting together rescue relief efforts for the northeastern area. We've got a lot of family and friends up in New Jersey and stuff, so we're gathering food supplies, generators, things like that.
That's awesome.
Kind of a joint effort between myself, my crew chief, friend of mine at drag races, Slayton, Full Motivation Racing. We're loading up race car haulers and taking them up to the Northeast to try and help some folks out. It's bad up there. It's tragedy, you know?
Yeah, it is. And that's awesome that you're helping out in that way, because it's going to be a long recovery for this turkey, especially up north, New Jersey, New York area. It's really, really bad.
It's too bad that West Virginia, they got all that snow, because, I mean, the hard part is getting trailers up in the snow mountains, you know?
You know, the problem is for a lot of folks, and I got a lot of family up there, you know, their homes fortunately survived the storm and really didn't take any damage. But, you know, it's 45, you know, 30-something degrees up there, and there's no heat, you know. So it's anything we can do to help them out and keep them moving. So I just picked up a couple of generators and met up at the rally point here, where we've got lots of people bringing in equipment. Supplies, food. It's nice. The racing community down here is really, really pulled together.
That's awesome.
It's a good group I've got here.
Well, good deal. How many other drivers you got running their haulers up there other than y'all?
Yeah, just us so far as I know. We're making our second trip. We sent one load up last night, and that was cleaned out by 9 o'clock this morning, and we're loading up and going back up again.
Ah, cool. Yeah, I had my generator sitting in my garage just in case anything happened.
I know, we did too. We only had to use it for a couple of minutes because the power did go out, and then after a while it came back on.
you know, in the Southeast, we get pounded by these things, you know, a couple times a year or at least once a year, so we're a little more prepared for this. And, you know, we're a little more spread out, too, so supply goes a little farther. But when you get, you know, such dense populations like New Jersey and New York, I got a call from some friends that, you know, they said, bring food, bring gasoline, you know, there's nothing. They got nothing, and they can't buy anything. And it's only been a couple of days without power now, so, I hope simulation starts to stabilize a little bit up there, because it's going to get bad, especially when people are out of food and water.
Yeah, I remember here when we had one of the hurricanes came through and took us out for 7 days without any power.
Isabel. That was Isabel.
It was Isabel.
Isabel was bad.
And tell you what, I was using the heck out of my generator, and I made sure I had lots of gas.
Yeah, but, you know, it's not any better for us, but we're more prepared for it because we go through it more often.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I had generators going, basically everybody, you know, Southeast, everything's electric, so if you got a generator, you plug it in and everything works. You know, our weather isn't as brutal as it is up there. So, you know, it's a little easier to survive that sort of thing down here. And if you live in a place like I am, you know, if food gets low, well, just wait to see what walks through the backyard, you know?
Yeah. It's going to be hard for them. I mean, they've got a lot.
Even new to prepare anything, like, because this hurricane is really big, but that usually never hits up in New Jersey, New York, very rarely. So,
is it?
I know it does, but they get not that bad.
No, well, you figure you're talking about a hurricane that's what?
It was 1,000 feet long.
1,000 miles wide.
I'm looking up at the sky and I'm still seeing, you know, there's a tail going by. You know, it's finally the first night that I actually see stars. And, you know, some of the clouds I'm looking at in the distance still have that wispy tail look. Tremendous storm. It was by far the largest I've seen in my life, and the big thing that really hurt the Northeast was it showed so much water up there. And, I mean, you know, all in New York, New Jersey, most of it's really flat. There's a lot of shoreline here. There's a lot of beach. People don't realize it. You know, Manhattan's an island.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Lord, yeah.
It was, now, the width of the hurricane was 1,000 miles wide.
Wide.
Yes, right. Not 1,000 feet. 1,000 feet will get you out to the road.
Feet. I didn't believe it at first, but there are some really cool pictures of it from space, from the satellites.
Oh, yeah.
I saw some of those. It looks really cool from space, but then you think, goodness, it causes a heck of a lot of damage.
It's absolutely horrific, and I just want to put it out to, you know, anybody that's on Facebook that wants to contact me, we're making a range drop point on the travel north, so that you can meet up and pick up generators, and I've got some water and things like that. Anybody who is listening from that area is looking for fuel, don't go out and wander aimlessly looking for it. Make the trip, if you can, to, you know, like the New Jersey Turnpike, I think, has fuel from what I understand. All of the rest areas are open and fueling. The lines are long, but they've got gas.
Yeah.
You know, pack up one vehicle with as many gas cans as you can and go out. That way, don't travel out in individual vehicles, because, you know, it's like the road warrior now, fuel is precious. But listen, and I don't want to be rude, but I got to get going here, because we're loading up this trailer, and it's heading back up, because there's people sitting in the cold and dark, and we got to get supplies going.
All right, we'll take it and let you boogie. We ain't going to kick your butt this time for running off so easy.
Yeah, I hear you. Next time, I'll call back in, and I'll be my usual comical self, but tonight it's just too serious of a situation going on.
Yeah.
All right.
I have my serious moments, and unfortunately, this is one of them.
All right, be safe.
All right, thanks for having me, guys.
All right, guys.
No problem, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah. That's awesome that he's able to help out. A lot of people are trying to contribute to this as much as possible, because I don't think, when this hurricane first started, I don't think anybody expected it to be as bad as this.
Yeah. I mean, most of the times, you know, they get hurricanes up there every so often, but they're not so big and huge. And that was the big thing, is because it was so wide, it was able to push so much water. And that's basically what got them, was all the water force that came from there. Even down here, they had some of it. Of course, most of it's like regular nor'easter, because that's basically what you're doing. As far as speed wise and what's pushing, because we were not hit as fully as they were.
No, we were not hit like directly. We got mostly the outside of the hurricane. It was still bad, but it's nothing really compared to up there. Like, there's this picture from New York where you usually would wait in line to get on the ferry to go to Ellis Island, and I've been there before. and it showed a picture of this wave just crashing against it, and all this water there flooded, and I could, and like the water was so high, I could not imagine how different and how affected that had to be with me being there and like walking the streets and knowing how high it is and what it's like there. When you then see a picture like that and you can think about what it had to be like, it really, really sinks in about what's happened there.
It's just tremendous. It's huge.
It's really bad. Did they know how long the eye was? How big the eye was of the hurricane?
No, I don't think they had the actual size on it that they ever said, but I mean, because that fluctuates depending upon how much low pressure it is.
Is my West Virginia mostly got snow. My cousin.
Oh, yeah, they
my,
got.
One of my cousins, like, had a picture from up there, and it shows all this snow. She's standing in 2 feet of snow, her and her little brother.
And it should be getting up to 36 inches.
Some
places
up
there.
Then she'll be saying, oh, yeah, I have no school. And I'll be like, oh, lucky you.
They already don't have any school. They're up to 2 feet already.
I know. And here I am sitting here. At least I got a 2-hour delay. That was nice. Even though it was sad because of the hurricane, but it's still nice to get up at 7 instead of 5.
Well, Jeff Burton lost his crew chief on Sunday.
Oh.
Drew Blickensdurfer. He resigned. That's, look at Blickensdurfer.
Oh, I thought you were like just joking. Oh, wow. That's interesting. I would not have been able to say that. I would have been like, Roger, you take it.
He's going to go back to the Ford camp and crew chief for Marcus Ambrose and the number 19, Richard Petty.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
He's been at Roush for, what, 9 years? So.
Please.
He's going to replace Mike Ford.
Really?
And let's see. Now that was Eric Amarillo's crew chief. Let's see. And then Todd Parrott is. They got all sorts of stuff already starting to go up.
Gee.
Now Shane Wilson, he's on Childress Racing. He's going to take him. Go be Jeff Burton's new crew chief.
Mm-hmm.
So.
That'll be good. That'll be interesting.
So, and then, let's see. There's still some other stuff going on here with Elliot Sadler and. Oh, boy.
Lots and lots of stuff.
Yearbook. Let's see. Oh, all the junk on the race from Martinsville. The breakdown, how many commercials. And
I know.
All that good stuff. Here's
all that fun stuff.
Now,
isn't all that fun.
Let's see, on the nationwide side.
Yes.
Scott Riggs is going to be driving the 0-3 car.
Mm-hmm.
And Richardson is also going to be in the 23 car. So they're going to, this first time in a long time they've had the two cars out together.
And they're going to be racing against each other and with each other, which would be good. And that's down in Texas.
Yep, and they got 47 cars on the preliminary list already.
Oh my, 47 already.
So
who all are those? Let's see.
Oh, you want to see the whole entry list?
No, we don't have to see the whole entry list. Just want to name a few. I see Ryan Newman will be driving the number
Ollie,
30.
Oh, let's see. Nur Ali was supposed to take in, drive the 75 for Rick Ware, but he was not approved to drive at Texas.
Oh.
So as of today, see, of course, Elliott's going to be there. Mike Wallace is going to be there. Austin Dillon, Scott Riggs in the 03, Danny Eflin in the 4. Stenhouse Jr. in the 6. Danica's going to be back out there.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, who's. They don't know who they're going to have driving the 13 car yet. It's owned by Jennifer Jo Cobb.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Denny Hamlin's going to be running the 18 car.
Oh,
Hal Martin. Hal Martin's going to be out there running. Mm-hmm. That's right. You weren't here. We had him on here the other week.
I'll say, I don't think I've interviewed him yet. There's Robert Richardson.
Yep.
Woo! That's
gonna
my buddy.
It's going to be sponsored by Tia Rosa.
Tia Rosa.
And Scott's going to be getting sponsored by, what is that, Wool Bros?
Yep. You said it right.
Crazy stuff.
Let's see. Of course, Kyle Busch is doing Monster Energy.
But like I said, that's 47 teams. Four of them going home.
Oh, man.
So. Got some people out there. Don't usually see. We've got several that are TBAs. The 74 and 75 car are both to be announced as who's driving it.
41
car is also going to be to be announced.
52 is to be announced.
No, that's who's sponsoring.
Oh, that's in the end.
Like I said, the 13.
Danica Patrick is going to be the 7.
Usually.
As usual.
She's gonna have she's gonna have Sega Sonic the Hedgehog on her car this time.
Ah,
with
Sonic.
With GoDaddy.
GoDaddy.
Oh gosh. What else? They had a little bit of rain out there at Martinsville. Slowed things up both Saturday and Sunday.
Yeah, because it started raining a little bit. We had to hit the road while the race was going, but we tuned into it on the radio, yeah. And we listened to the race, and it rained a little bit while we were driving.
The fun part was when I walked in to the track on Saturday, they were just doing the qualifying. Timothy Peters had just started to do his qualifying, and he qualified P1.
Wow.
So I went over and talked to him
awesome.
For a while. A lot of the other guys, too. But, he wasn't upset that he didn't win. Race, he's pretty laid back with that.
You gotta stay confident. You can't get yourself down. You just gotta keep doing what you're doing and trying. Do your best at it.
He's just sit there. He's gonna plug away at it, and just do what he's got to do. Finishing eighth was not a bad finish. He gained, I think, 1 point up, so he's only 25 out. They've got three more races to go.
We got three?
For the trucks.
Oh, I was saying, wait, what? Anyways, for the trucks. How many for the Nationwide
still has...
And then what about Sprint Cups?
They've got three more races to go to. Texas, Phoenix, and Homestead.
And then what about Sprint Cups?
Sprint Cups. They should have 4 left, I believe. Oh. Still ain't what I want. 30. Yeah, they've got 3 left.
They
three
left
also.
Wow, it's getting towards the end of the season already. Oh, I'd be sad.
Well, then they can watch our shows, and that way they can get back to watching them again.
Yeah, that way they all can come
and talk.
Everybody's got
Texas, Phoenix, and Homestead to race.
Mm-hmm. And Al Pierce told us that he'd be down in Texas.
He's going to be
Phoenix.
And all of them.
He's going to be in all of them.
We ain't going to see him until at the end of the year.
I know. What I'm missing.
Oh, gosh.
Al's funny. He's good to have on the show. Cracks me up. I'm never going to forget that story he told me.
The Dover.
Yes, about. Why did you run from the Dover?
And he said, "You don't know much about racing there, boy."
Yeah, he didn't. Oh, Lord. I could just imagine if I was in the audience. I would have been like, who do you think you are? Where did you come from? Why would you ever ask? Why did you not open the door?
What can I say? One of our sponsors, by the way.
TheAuctionHotspot.com.
Yes.
Awesome.
You go down there, you sign up, and you get 10 free bucks to use for selling your stuff.
Hmm.
If you do a standard listing on an auction, it's free.
Really?
Yeah, it's not like eBay where you're going to get charged no matter what you do. The only thing they do there, once you sell, you'll have a selling fee, and it's still cheaper than eBay.
That's awesome. Thank you for that. Thank you for sponsoring us. It means a lot to us here. Is that our other caller? It's Let's Talk Racing.
Happy Halloween.
Wah-ha-ha-ha-ha.
Hello.
Anybody there?
Yep, I'm here.
Okay. I was going to say, wait, did we
thought
scare
we scared her off.
Away.
How you doing, Hannah?
Good, how are you guys?
We're having fun.
We're doing great, having a lot of fun here.
That's awesome.
Covering some of the sad things also that's been happening over the past couple of days up north here.
Yeah.
And one of our friends, he's taking his race hauler. He runs Southern Modified, and they're loading it up. They already took it up once, and they're loading up to help out the people.
Yep, and
taking stuff up there, supplies, all sorts of stuff, gas if they can get it, you know.
For the effects of Hurricane Sandy in New Jersey and some of the other northern states.
That's awesome, and that's great that they're helping out.
Yeah, well, we got good people in the race community.
Yeah, some awesome good people.
We got lots of us that got big haulers, you know?
We all got big hearts.
Yeah, that is definitely a plus, having all the big haulers.
Yeah. But anywho, so how's everything going for you? Did you finally get to enjoy everything at the Combine here at Langley?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, Thursday came around, and we all said our goodbyes, and I was like, Dad, can we just stay another day? And he's like, it's over. Like, why do you want to stay another day? I'm like, I don't know.
There's lots of stuff around here to go visit, that's
really?
For sure.
Lots of stuff.
If I remember, I saw some pictures of you running around checking out stuff, didn't we?
Yeah, I was running around. We went and saw, I think it's Fort Monroe.
Yeah.
I saw Fort Monroe.
We went to the beach and stuff, and it was weird walking to the beach and it being October, in the middle of October, and people are all swimming in the water.
Did you get to see Yorktown, like around that beach area, and you get to see some of the historical sightings?
No, we didn't. We just happened to actually drive into Fort Monroe, and then we made it a point to go see the beach, because I don't live anywhere near a beach, so we made a point to go over there. So that's about all we went to.
Aww.
Well, you can always hop out to Anderson Ranch Dam or go to the Trinity Mountain Lakes.
Mm-hmm.
There you go, yeah. That's definitely a beautiful sight up there. We spend our summers up there most of the time if we're not racing.
Oh, yeah. I remember those. I hate to see what they're like now, because back when I was doing it, it was before you were born.
Oh, Lord.
That was back in the late 70s, early 80s.
Oh, boy.
I wasn't born then.
That's why I said you weren't born.
No, I won't either. Oh, Lord.
But it used to be really nice up there, and back then, it was most everything out there was all dirt trails.
Yeah, they've got some main paved roads up through, like, pine and stuff now, but they had a pretty nasty storm about 2 years ago, and it rerouted the river, and it took out a bunch of cabins, and
what?
All kinds of stuff. So, I mean, they're still even recovering from that, as bad as that is.
Wow.
Up in the Trinities or up at Anderson Ranch?
Up at Anderson Ranch.
Okay.
But yeah, it's still definitely pretty up there. That is one half that I do like about Idaho, is that we've got some gorgeous places here.
You know, one of the funny things they used to do in the summertime, me and some of the guys, we were stationed out at Mountain Home Air Force Base.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, hush. Anyway, of course, it's time for all the potatoes to start being harvested and everything. And they used to load the trucks so full, and they all drove down sandy roads.
Oh, geez.
And you could drive along and collect a couple of bushes within a quarter of a mile. And it'd be perfectly fine because they were just falling off and falling in the sand, so it's like, you know, throwing it down into a catcher's mitt.
Right.
So, I mean, back then, it was, hey, go back and have taters.
No.
Tater salad and home fries and french fries, anything you want to make out of your
suckers.
Oh, yeah, I get made fun of
because,
I mean, I live in Idaho, home with the potatoes, and for some unknown reason, I do not like potatoes. I mean, I can't eat potatoes.
Wow.
Oh, goodness.
Interesting. Next,
too bad you didn't stick around here longer. I could have fixed you a potato dish that you would have liked.
Probably. The only kind of potatoes I'll eat is, like, cheesy potatoes, to the point where it's so cheesy you can't taste the potato. Other than that...
What?
I make a lemon chicken and potato dish.
Lemon
Yes.
That sounds really good.
And it tastes really good. You'd be surprised.
There's also a thing called gravy. Put that on mashed potatoes. That's really, really good.
Oh, yeah, Dad. I'd be the one to drown out the taste of potato with gravy.
Yep, same here.
Jeez.
That's just because I love gravy.
Anyway, since we got a little more time with you, go ahead and give us a decent bio about how you got into racing and what's your future plans you got going that you're looking at.
Well, I started off racing go-karts at about 5 years old. My dad had always raced before me. He was a Rocky Mountain Challenge Series champion in 2007. He raced modified before I was born, he raced go-karts when he was little. So first thing he was going to do is put his oldest kid in go-karts and see if they liked it, and I was hooked. So, yeah, I started off at age five and kind of stuck around in go-karts for a really long time, won myself a couple state championships with that, and then at age 12 or 13, I can't remember, we decided that it was time for me to adjust the full body cart, and we stuck me in a truck. 13 in a truck, and a lot of the tracks I ran at, I couldn't even get in the pit, so I couldn't run a full series until I was 14, I believe. I ran a full series in the truck then, and came home with fourth in points in rookie of the year, and I think this current year right now was my first year in an actual car, like full body car.
That's awesome, though. That's good.
Yeah, I like it. It's different than a truck. It took me a little while, but I figured it out, and I definitely liked it.
So, I know that when we had you on here that short time before, we tapped on the fact that Dad isn't listened to too much when it comes to racing advice, but you listen to the crew chiefs.
Yes. The whole father-daughter thing plays into where, of course, me being 15, the teenage daughter thing.
Yeah, it's okay. I'm 17 and anywhere I can be.
Yeah, we do argue. He's also a race car driver himself, as I said. So he does the whole driving advice, but he tells me advice on how to drive how he drives. And so we argue with each other, and so finally my crew chief will just take away his radio. And my crew chief could probably tell me the same thing my dad just told me, and I would still probably just listen to my crew chief instead of my dad. It's just a mentality thing I'm
going to
have to get over with age.
Yeah, I tell you what, one of the things that might cure you of that is get into a big race and let him be the spotter, and then you would have to.
Oh boy, Roger. You're the one that always wants a challenge.
No, I'm seriously. I mean.
Oh, I understand that. It is in theory, but man, that'd be interesting.
That would be a way to help detune you of ignoring him.
Yeah. We went through that one time. My crew chief went to the Bristol race this year and flew out from Bristol to Mexico on vacation, so I was stuck without a crew chief for a weekend, and we had three main events in one night. And so my dad got to spot me in the truck, all three main events, and we worked pretty well together. With the truck, though, he normally doesn't say much because I have mirrors all over, and I really do use my mirrors, so he doesn't really tell me inside, outside. He just lets me drive the truck for the most part. But, yeah, we got into a feud, definitely, while we were in the truck in the first main event. And after the first main event, I think we got our anger out for the day, and the first race out for the day. And the rest of the two main events, we worked together just perfect, and it all worked out actually really good.
After that one little fight, everything's fine. Get stuff done. It's like, okay, let's just do this.
We've had it out. We can settle down. Let's roll.
All right.
Well, y'all should do that at home then before you go racing. That way it's all done.
Oh, I know. That's probably a really good idea.
Now, what... I know you've gone to the combine. How do you think you rated against the other drivers? I know this is a very hard thing for you to talk about here.
It's a toughie.
Well, let me say first off, there was a ton of talent this year at the combine. I haven't been to the combine previously. This is my first year, so I can't compare it to previous years. But there's definitely a lot of amazing difficult, I mean, task because we're all there for obviously the same reason, but, you know, I feel like I did really good all together. I've never been on iRacing. You guys know what iRacing is?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. I've never been on it before or anything like that, and they told me that we have to do a simulator test in there. I was freaking out because I use video game simulator stuff. We just don't have that in Idaho. So I've never been exposed to it or anything like that. And, oh, I was so concerned with that, and I actually ended up being one of the, I guess, as they told me, one of the faster girls out of all of them on the iRacing. So that was a real confidence booster in the physical test.
That's awesome. Good job. You good girl.
Yeah, the nice thing about the iRacing, it doesn't cost anything to crash.
Exactly. It's a push of a button and you got yourself a brand new race car.
There you go.
Oh, Roger.
But, one of my computer store ventures, I actually have a partnership with iRacing. And we build some high-end speed computers, and every one that goes out comes with a free three-month iRacing subscription.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely super fun. I've been trying to talk the dad into it now that I've done it, I'm hooked, and I personally think it's really beneficial to it all. I mean, it helped me having never been to Langley before.
Yeah, and Langley's on the package.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, and then when it came to the track time, I mean, I was a nervous wreck because I was the second person or third person out on the track the whole day.
Yeah.
I was terrified because I really didn't get to watch anyone beforehand, and I was the first girl, so I had to go out there and kind of set the bar. But
oh boy.
Well, did you get a chance to talk with C.E. Falk?
I didn't. I was running around, and he would talk to some other people. Oh, just kidding. Yes, I did.
All right. I'm gonna get you on iRacing, and I'm gonna put you in the wall for that one.
Oh Lord. Now, can't you be nice and behave for one day?
No, it's no fun that way.
I know. I have the hardest job. I have to try to find a way to keep him in line and behave. I've never succeeded because he's just...
You know what rule one is?
So mischievous. What?
Give up.
Well, I'm not going to. I'm going to keep trying. That someone tells me he'll drive me insane one day, but it'll be okay.
Short putt in your case.
Uh-huh. We're family, all right? So okay. I have a right to mess with you a little bit on that.
See, Hannah, you're used to this. You and your dad, so this is me and my niece, so what the hell?
Yeah, there you go.
Just do that little song, It's a Family Affair.
Yeah, family. Oh,
so now that you've gone through the combine, and I know they're going to have, what, four drivers that they're going to release information about, I forget when they were going to do that. In December, or?
Yeah, I was told expect around the end of December because, of course, they have to wait for their whole race season to end. And so I told about the end of December, and I believe we're fighting for what we were told is two positions. Is what 17 of us were fighting for. So it's definitely tough competition for sure.
All right, bear with me here. I'm looking through one of the people that I know that works with you guys.
Oh boy. He's still scrolling. He's been scrolling for a while, so let's see how long this will take.
Yeah.
Might be a while, so hopefully you ain't a rush to anywhere.
I don't... Yeah. I think she may have sent it to me through the chat room that we have sitting open during the show.
Well, check your chat room.
Right? Well, it doesn't save the messages.
Well, but anyway, then.
Yeah, I don't know if you know Ellen Richardson or not.
I might. I don't know. I'm terrible with names. That is one thing I'm going to have to work on. I couldn't tell you a person's name for the life of me when I could describe them.
Well, anyway, yeah, she, when we were talking to you guys and we were talking about how many they were going to take, she sent me a thing, said it was going to be four of you, and I'm pretty sure she said it was going to be at the end of December, like you were saying, that they were going to announce everybody out. I mean, it's nice what they've got done going for everybody. Some of the people we've had on here before and met them before, whether at the combine last year or just basically being here talking to people. So it's interesting.
Yeah, the program's definitely, I mean, a great program that they've got going too. it helps find people me out in the middle of nowhere that might not have the opportunities that other people have. It helps a lot of people out. It's a great program that's got going on at Red Racing.
Yep.
Yeah, the good news and bad news part to it, and I hate to say this because I know people that fit every description that they want to have out there. They do have age limits, so if you got older women that want to be able to show their stuff because they never had the D4D program before,
mm-hmm.
can't get into it. And if you... And I'll give you a prime example. Next year, if you're coming out here, let me know ahead of time. I'll get you hooked up with somebody that knows that track really well, too. He's got 105 wins out at Langley Speedway.
Oh, gee, that's awesome.
I spot for him. That's how he manages to win, okay?
Yep.
There you go.
Keep his butt out of trouble. Anyway.
You got to give him a little bit of credit, though.
Yeah, he's a good driver.
Because he listens to you and everything, so.
Well, The code I have when I spot for somebody, I'm going to tell you to do something.
Do it.
Don't think about it. You do it then, in that moment.
Just do it.
Because if you wait too long and think about it, it ain't going to be there no more.
They get really mad about that, and they tell me, that I need to sit on the inside or outside. And I used to hesitate. By the time I go for it, it'd be too late, and it would probably end up badly. So I'm getting a lot better about just reacting. Right.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing, because there's been several times that he thinks he can push a little bit harder when he's up a little higher, and I'll tell him,
and you're like,
get
no.
down now, and he tries to gas a little bit more, and it kicks the car a little loose, and guess what, the car behind him slides up beside that rear end, and when he decides to come down, they go skate through that corner sideways.
Yeah. Oh.
But he's good enough to hang on, but just like anything else, you don't want to have to fix something if you don't have to.
Yep, very much.
Exactly.
But, anyway, back to the combine stuff. The day I was out there on Wednesday, we were trying to do interviews upstairs, but apparently you guys were behind schedule, and during the lunch break, y'all were supposed to have an earlier lunch. And y'all actually came down during the lunch break when I was supposed to be talking with y'all, so everybody went to eat lunch. So I only managed to catch...
We were expected to have lunch, I guess, right at 11:30 noon, and we didn't get to lunch till 1:32, so we're definitely behind a little bit pushing out cars and stuff. But all in all, we ended almost right on time.
Yeah. I was up in the suite next to Adai. We were doing the interviews in there.
Oh, gotcha.
So, we were able to grab Dylan and Amber. And then y'all were back out having to run again. And it's not like you can just come across the track easy while somebody's running. It's not like... They need to have an under the track tunnel like some of the tracks do, you know?
Like
Iowa, where you go exit in and out of the track by going underneath the racetrack. That's cool how they got that set up.
Oh, yeah. Most of the bigger tracks will have it. We were at Martinsville. And Martinsville got a little, about 3-person wide tunnel you can go through underneath the track to turn 4.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever been to Martinsville. I've only been to a couple tracks now that I think about it. Langley's the fourth track or fifth track I've ever been to, which is, we're thinking about that now.
Now, I will tell you, if you can run good at Langley, you're going to be able to succeed in a lot of different tracks and in a lot of different vehicles. Langley is one of those flat tracks.
Flat.
That is very hard to get used to. That's why I said, if you're out here next year, let me know. I'll get you to talk with my friend.
All right, sounds good. Thank you.
So what else you got going on after the compound? Are you going back to do your regular racing until you hear something, or do you already got something lined up possibly?
For next year?
Yeah.
Right now everything's kind of up in the air. I always have, we're hoping to continue forward again with hopefully a West ride. That'd be awesome. I made a couple West races this year with the Thompson Motorsports out of Jerome, Idaho. I ran with them, and they were my main sponsorship. They were who I ran with in my super late model this year. And so hopefully we'll get to run a couple more rest races, maybe even full-time. That would be where I'd like to be this year.
Yeah.
But I always do have, my dad runs a super late model, and he always said the day I beat him is the day he'll stop racing. That day came this year, and so we always have that little bit of a fallback plan that if nothing comes out this year, I have a truck and a super late that I can run. So that's always the fallback plan.
Oh, goodness. Done whooped his pants on him, did you?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, that's always been the rule with him and my brother. I mean, we started off go-kart racing, and he used to race with us. And the day came where him and I finally got in the same class, and I beat him one day, and he's just like, okay. And he threw in the towel, and he focused go-kart racing on us, and then he raced cars, and it was my turn to race cars, and he, the day I beat him, he threw in the towel. He still never beat me in the truck, though.
Oh.
I've never beat him, my bad.
That's all right. I figured that's what you meant.
It's okay. We know what you meant.
Yeah.
You're 15. What can you say?
You're doing pretty good, though. You're doing good. Keep it up.
Yes, yes, yes. Always like to see the young drivers doing good. I know quite a few that, I mean, we've had one on the show 13 years old. And it's one of them, a friend of mine, he's got snatched up by Kevin Harvick for a 5-year contract.
That is crazy.
Till he was 18 years old, he's under Kevin Harvick's wing.
That's awesome. That's crazy. He'll have a great opportunity through there, too.
Well, he's actually known Kevin a while. He lives next door to him, and they race on their go-kart tracks together.
Oh, that's awesome.
So he said he loves it. He gets to beat Kevin quite a bit.
Nah.
isn't that kid back there, Gray Galding? Is he from back east?
That is who we're talking about.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, see, I just watched something about him on feed or something the other day, how he had got the whole Krispy Kreme sign for 5 years or something.
Yep.
Krispy Kreme. Yes. Good job.
Give us those fat pills.
I like a Krispy Kreme every now and then. It's amazing. I love those with Krispy Kreme.
You have to see the bus they've got set up, too. It's pretty cute.
The bus?
Yeah, they have the old... You got to understand, Krispy Kreme is an old company that's been around for a long time.
But that's
and we're talking
so
about
good.
Buses that were. I think they have a bus that was redone back in like the 1940s, 1950s style.
Oh, that's cool.
It's all white with green striping down it,
and
the Krispy Kreme logos on it. It is sweet. Look on Gray's page and see what you can find. I think, pretty sure he's got pictures of that on there.
Okay, yeah, I'll look at it. When I saw it on there, I got it on Instagram. Looking at some cool pictures, but I never really got the time to sit down and look. I was just snooping around, being the 15-year-old girl I am, and snooping. You know how that works.
Yeah, I'm trying to get him to come up here and go to a charity race that we're having in December. Put him on my race team.
There you go.
But I haven't gotten okay on that yet. I got him and talking to Sergio Pena.
Oh, yeah, I've met Sergio. I think I met him. I met him at a race, I think, last year. He's a really cool guy.
Yes, he is. Tall old boy. I tell you.
Yeah, no.
Tall drink of water.
Made me feel like a midget.
Just think of Mark Martin standing by him. And Mark Martin really feel more like a midget. That's like when Mark Martin and Michael Waltrip have those commercials together. You know, I don't think you can stand up to me or something like that. Measure up to
you can say
like
all
that.
This and you can be the one that gets in all the trouble. But then again, that usually happens with you. But
yeah, I always feel really short stuff out when I'm a cheerleader, so I always feel really short in high school and in cheer and stuff. And then, as ironic as it is, I go to the races. And for the most part, all the racers are really short. Started to notice that. They're all really short.
Yeah, I mean, it's surprising because when the camera crews go around taking pictures, they're usually shooting up, so it makes them look taller.
Yeah,
I met Kenny Wallace at our race thing we had at our local track, and he raced in our class, and I mean, even he's really not that tall. I was really surprised.
Yep. I think I'm taller than Kenny is even. But yeah, Kenny, Dinger, Mark Martin, Juan Pablo, even Tony Stewart's not as tall as people think he might be.
Yeah, Jamie McMurray's also really short. He did. Yep. He was racing Super National, the go kart races in Vegas, I think 2 years ago, and I have a picture with him, and I was like 12, and me and him are almost the same height. It was pretty funny.
Yeah, the day of the tall drivers is starting to dwindle away. DJ's no longer there. Walter's no longer there. Are you doing the sound effects tonight?
Isn't it shrinking down?
Okay. I thought you might do the Wicked Witch of the West. I'm melting.
No.
That would be Halloween theme.
Yeah, I know it would. I'm dressed as the Wicked Witch of the West.
What are you supposed to be?
I'm just a masquerade.
You do realize, Hannah, we do this is video, right?
Yeah, this is all live and video and fun. And I'm dressed up.
You know that in video. That's very cool.
Yeah, I'm still in my Halloween gig and outfit, so I got like a purple and gold mask on. I got like the long, flowy black skirt and a purple shirt and all this glitter and stuff everywhere.
That's awesome. As we're like sitting here talking right now, in the bathroom getting ready to take little siblings trick-or-treating, and so I'm all dressed up as a pirate.
Awesome.
Yeah.
When you get back later on tonight, go to youtube.com/pitwall.
Okay.
And you will find a plethora, a whole big plethora of the shows that we've done.
Sweet. All right, cool.
It usually takes, after we're done, I'll start the upload, and about 45 minutes to an hour later, it'll be available to watch.
Cool, yeah, I'll definitely get on and look at that.
And pass that on out to your friends. That way they can listen to your interview.
Can watch, and you can be like, hey guys, you listen to my interview, and they can hear about everything you're up to.
Oh yeah, that'll be on Facebook as soon as that thing's on YouTube.
All right, well, I'm going to go ahead and let you go, because I'm sure it's, about 5 o'clock there now?
It's about 6:02.
That's right, 2 hours. I'm sorry.
I do. Yeah.
What time are y'all supposed to start trick or treating?
Well, the parents already left me because I'm the one that's always late to everything. And so I have me and my friend here. We're last minute putting together costume people, and yeah, we're just waiting. But yeah, it's about 6, so we'll probably start 6:37.
All right, well, you go have yourself a good, fun time. If you want to, go ahead and run through your sponsors again, and we'll let you get rolling.
All right, yeah, I'll just run through those real quick. I got to definitely thank Thompson Motorsports, of course, for the awesome season they've put together, and they've always provided a great car for me. And then Rich Thompson Trucking and Coca-Cola, Valley Brake. I mean, I had a ton of people help me out this year that I couldn't have done this race season without. Dude, thank you guys for having me on the show, too.
No problem.
Well, it was nice having you. We'll have to do it again some more.
Yeah, definitely. Just let me know, and I'll make time for sure.
Just let me know. I'm ready to go back skiing again up to Bogus Basin. I miss it.
Yeah. Hey, let me know. We'll make room for you. You can come hang out down here.
I will, too. I love some snowboarding, so I'll have to come, too. I'll have to drag me along, whether he likes to or not.
You just have to make sure you can go fast. What was that? I missed it. Hannah?
I'm sorry, what was that?
Yeah, I missed what you were trying to say.
Oh, yeah.
About going fast.
We haven't got any snow yet, so there's no way we can bomb the hill yet. There's no snow at all down here yet, so.
Sad.
We might be waiting until February to go snowboarding.
When I was doing it, I even would do double diamonds.
Oh man, you gotta tell her the one story.
I texted her about the one thing where.
Oh, where you went up the hill and then you landed to the land, everybody was clapping?
No, I didn't tell her about that one.
I'll tell her that one later.
I was talking about breaking a set of skis across moguls.
Oh, that one. That story. I had to drive up for 18, 14 hours with him up to Iowa, and he told me like every single ski story he could think of.
No, you didn't get all of them.
Not all of them, but there was plenty. There was plenty. They were funny too.
Oh yeah, I used to be a daredevil when it came to snowboarding and stuff like that, but I broke my wrist a couple of years ago, and
that was the end of it, right?
Oh yeah, that was the end of it. I'm just a little preservative snowboarder.
I love snowboarding. It's so fun.
Oh gosh.
I love it. I've never skied, so I've always just been a snowboarding girl.
Alright, well go have fun. Let's get you out of here.
Alright, thanks for having me guys.
Alright, talk to you later.
Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Bye bye.
That was a lot of fun.
Oh gosh. I don't think I told you about the one where I broke the skis.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, you did.
Okay.
Trust me, I remember that one. I thought it was funny.
Yep, I was telling her about just going through a mogul field and slid across the moguls, went sideways, came down, and.
Well, I have a little bit of announcement. This doesn't have to deal with racing, but anybody in the Virginia area. My school is
Hampton Roads.
On the Hampton Peninsula. Roads, Peninsula, Newport News area.
I don't think
area.
They're gonna come from DC or
well,
anything.
Well, no, not DC, but anybody from around, you know, Hampton and Newport News, Hampton Roads, all that. If you could come to a play at my school, Woodside High School, we are doing the play The Crucible, which will fit with Halloween that just happened about Salem Witch Trials. I was lucky enough to get one of the leads as Mary Warren. If you could please come see the play, it's on the 8th, 9th, and 10th of November. It's at Woodside High School. You can easily type it up in MapQuest. It'll give you an address. It's at 7 o'clock. The tickets are $8 at the door. You could come and gladly support the drama program. And you can come see me. You can maybe meet some good racing buddies.
Can you do this?
What?
Turn around and pat yourself on your back.
Oh, ha, ha, ha. There, you happy?
Okay. Everybody, enjoyed having the show on tonight.
Yeah, and I'm glad to be back, and I was able to have a free
fun.
Wednesday and come be back on the show.
Everybody, see you next week.
See you later.
See
you.
Wrong mouse.
Hi, my name is Natalie Sather. I drive the 94 K&N Lady Eagle Safety Wear, Butler Built Seats, Bell Helmets,
Thank
Hooker
you.
Harness Seat Belts, number 94 at South Boston Speedway. Be sure to listen to Let's Talk Racing TV.
I'm Sam Hunt, drive a 42 car. I want to thank Let's Talk Racing.
Hey guys, I'm Daytona 500 winner Trevor Bain, and thank you for watching Let's Talk Racing.
Hi, I'm Robert Richardson Jr., driver of the number 23 Dodge Challenger for R3 Motorsports in the NASCAR Nationwide Series, and you're watching Let's Talk Racing.
I'm Teddy Peter, driver of the number 17 Toyota in the NASCAR Camp World Truck Series, and you're listening to Let's Talk Racing.
Let's Talk Racing is brought to you by PC Doctors, Computer Sales and Services. This doctor still makes house calls. And also Hampton Incredible Tees and Signs, both located at 1248 North King Street in Hampton, Virginia.